In this video, I'm going to talk about the new album by the Winery Dogs called Three, released on February 3rd through the Three Dog Music label. This is a super group consisting of three musicians, Mike Portnoy, originally from Dream Theater, Billy Sheehan, who has played with Mr. Big, and Richie Kotzen, who has played with both Mr. Big and Poison. This is a band that was formed not too long ago. Their influences are both classic rock of the 60s and 70s, as well as some alternative rock of the 90s. This is their third album, aptly titled Three. So let's talk about it. Songs are mostly hard rock. Richie Kotzen is the lead vocalist. He reminds me a lot of Chris Cornell. They have a similar vocal style. The songs have a lot of guitar shredding and a lot of technical bass playing. This is an album for people who like virtuoso guitar and bass playing, but make no mistake, they also write some good hooks. The opening track, Xanadu, has some pretty catchy choruses and is a memorable song. On Song Mad World, we hear some different vocal styles. For example, Richie Kotzen lets out some falsetto vocals on this one. And on this track, it goes into more of a funk direction, maybe similar to like the Red Hot Chili Peppers. It's still very fun and bouncy. It's just very upbeat and a really good song. I also enjoyed the song called Stars. This one reminded me a lot of Soundgarden. It was a little heavier. The guitars were distorted, but I wouldn't call it a heavy song. It was more of a space rock type of song where they did some atmospheric sounds. They did some experimentation. It was kind of like a throwback to 70s space rock, but with a 90s sound. I also like the song Pharaoh, another one that reminded me of Soundgarden, but more from their later years, maybe like Down on the Upside, like that album. A song that captures a 90s essence, but still had some interesting tones. They had some guitar riffs that sounded like it had some Middle Eastern undertones, and it was another song with a lot of bass guitar playing that was in the forefront. They have a song called The Red Wine, and it was interesting because it was the longest song on the album at 7.5 minutes. The first 5 minutes of the song was a typical blues rock song with what you would expect from this album, but the last 3 minutes, it was an extended jam session, and I thought it was pretty cool because they did take some time just to do some interesting guitar solos and bass playing, and that was all during the last 3 minutes of the song. Probably one of my favorites in the album was called Rise. I like this to remind me a lot of the band Cream, maybe something from the Disraeli Gears album. They went for that 60s rock sound as opposed to some of the other songs that were more centered in the 90s. A really catchy song with some great vocal harmonies. I like how the guitar and the bass play along to each other. It's a fun track, one of the catchier ones on the album. If you're a fan of the band Mr. Big, I recommend checking out a song called Gaslight. It reminded me of one of those old like Mr. Big albums from the late 80s. It was very fast-paced, it was very energetic, lots of virtuoso guitar playing, a lot of bass playing. It was very catchy, and I also like how they use the term gaslight. That's like a term that has been brought into the forefront in recent days. It's very catchy, kind of song that has that memorable chorus. They also do some arena rock. So, for example, the song The Vengeance was really fun. It was very upbeat. I like the vocals of that one. They did some very different vocal styles, and it was a catchy song. I like the drumming on that one. It had a throwback sound to that 80s hard rock with a cowbell sound. So it was another pretty cool track. I would say most of the album is very energetic and fast-paced. It's a lot of high-energy rock music, but there was one track where they slowed it down, and that's called Lorelei. That was a slower blues-based song. I like that one as well. It had some pretty cool falsetto vocals, some nice guitar playing. A song reminded me of maybe Whitesnake from the 80s, like the early 80s, but kind of like a slower blues rock. It was a pretty good song. The song Breakthrough had some pretty cool guitar tones, and they were used on that song. They experimented a little more. They used a little bit more reverb, more delay, and that created some interesting tones. It was catchy. It had a nice quality to it. It has some nice hooks, and that was another one that I enjoyed. So I really don't have any complaints with this album. The musicianship was top-notch. These are all legends in their craft. The songwriting was very good. The production is very clean and crisp. It's one of the few albums where you can hear every instrument very clearly, and the guitar and bass are almost like played equally, and one doesn't dominate the other. I think this album is more geared towards fans of hard rock, and maybe bands like Van Halen or Journey or any other those types of bands that I mentioned throughout this review. I think it's more the type of band that's for people who like virtuoso playing as opposed to those simple three-chord rock songs. You're not going to really get that in this album. And it's not that. It's definitely, if you like, guitar shredding, if you like that, like, those like bass players who they're not just going to play the notes, they're going to go crazy up and down the neck, and that's what you get on this album. It's very high top-notch playing on this. My score, 8 out of 10. Let me know in the comments of what you thought. I'm going to add another playlist. So these are 2023 album reviews, and these are starting to build up. I think I'm up to maybe 10 or 11 at this point. We're into February already. The year's moving fast. So that's all. Thanks for watching. For the rest of the week, I probably have some more anniversary reviews. I have something from Iggy Pop, Van Halen, Judas Priest. Those are the ones that I remember off the top of my head. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.